हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू एंड वेलकम बैक आवर ऑनलाइन क्लास साइंस 8th स्टैंडर्ड। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू आवर 17th चैप्टर, दैट इज द पोल्यूशन ऑफ एयर एंड वाटर। सो इन द लास्ट वीडियो ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट दैट, व्हाट आर द पोल्यूशंस ऑफ एयर एंड व्हाट आर द इफेक्ट्स, एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड। बट स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ वाटर पोल्यूशन। व्हाट इज दैट वाटर पोल्यूशन एंड इट्स ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, बट today in this video we are going to discuss what are its effects. If the water pollution will be then what it will affect to the human lives or the other animals or the plants. Okay, we'll discuss what is that effects by that water pollution, we'll discuss in this video. So let us see the effects of water pollution are far reaching, as it affect our oceans, lakes, rivers and groundwater resources. The main effects of water pollution are stated below. That means generally what happened, that the waters are, whenever we get the pollutions of that our ponds water, lake water, river water, ocean water, then it will be created by the different, this we are getting the pollution with different sources, different way. Okay, by the mainly human activities, but what are the things mainly we have to discuss, how this water things are that getting that pollutants. Water means like it is present in, now suppose ocean, how it is polluting, in the river how it is polluting, in the lakes how it is polluting. So what are that sources that where we are getting that surface of that water, how it is getting the pollutants, we will discuss. Okay, and what are the effects, the eutrophication. Okay, stated below what is eutrophication, effects on the aquatic life, effects on the health, effects on the potable water. So first of all we'll discuss about that, what is that eutrophication. You know that friends, whenever that agriculturals we are doing that vegetations, that time what happening, that we are applying that more that what pesticides and our in what is that our fertilizers to get that more crops, that we are applying that agricultural vegetation propagation or vegetative propagation in China. So what happening that in agriculture we are, whenever we are applying this chemical substances, this chemical substances are making harmful for that aquatic animals. This especially is called as what is that eutrophication. Okay, next we will discuss about that effects on the aquatic life. Okay, those fishes, frogs, snakes, dolphins, what are they living in that ponds or that in water, that they are what happening, they will be face the problems, because whenever that chemical substances are releasing from that industries and that it will mix with that water, then those who are living in that, they will get that more problem or their health problem or that all that troubleness it will get. They cannot live, they cannot survive their lives in that water. So because of that water will get the pollutants. Okay, so next one, effects on the health. You know that friends, if there is no potable water, then what will get, if we will get that potable water, means we can get that or get healthy. If you will see that water, if it is pollutant, that means it cannot be transparent, like you will see. Okay, and we will see there is no color and like that no smell, such water we can drink very well and it is good for health. But if there is smell, due to that chemical substances are present in that water, that's why it is getting the smell, so we cannot take that water. If we take that water, then compulsory our health will get the problems. Such like if we drink that surface of water like that, mixing with the chemicals or other things, then we will face the dysentery, cholera and so many diseases, that whatever that contaminant of that water, that we will get that water, some disease special that like diarrhea, cholera, dysentery, like this, which one we are saying, that fever, flu, and there are so many way that because of that water only. Okay, so mainly health problem will get. Effects on the potable water, I told that if that potable water means what is that, drinking water. Potable water means drinking water. So which one which is suitable for the drinking. Okay, suppose you will go for direct water ponds, can you drink that water? No, because it is contaminated with the other substances like chemical substances, microorganisms and so many other things. So directly we cannot take that which water, ponds water or the river water, like that directly we cannot take. So because it is contaminated, so that after filtering or that after whenever it is suitable for us, we can drink it. So that is called as a potable water. Okay. So next we will discuss about that prevention of water pollution. How we can do this prevention? Okay. How can it protect? Like we can take it prevention. So water pollution can be controlled by the giving proper treatment to the waste and by using the following methods. If whatever the waste things in our day to life, whatever the waste things where it is coming out, that we have to manage properly. We should not mix with the water. We should apply that proper way. Then if you do this treatment, then compulsory we can do that prevention of air water pollution. Okay students, so suppose we are sending directly, what is that, our pipelines to that river or ponds. Those are that industrial pipelines. That through that what happening? It is mixing that chemical substances, oil and so many unwanted things. It is mixing with that water. Those getting that water pollutants. So we should not, we have to control that. We have to make another run away and which one can dispose of. Okay. Next one, sewage. You know that friends, how's all that our bathing waters or that our kitchen room water, all we are making mixing with that what? Sewage water. That sewage treatment, if you do that, it does not mix with the other, or it does not make that pollution to that environment also. Okay. And fertilization. So it is a very important thing for the farmers and crops and whichever we are getting that whenever we are applying that fertilizers, it is chemical substances. So whenever that water flows, water rain will come, that water one place to another surface, it will mix and all that water bodies will mix, that water things will become that contaminants. So in that fertilizers, if that chemical substances are there which are making that harmful for the health also, for aquatic animals as well as also for human activities. So we have to use special, almost all you have to try to use that manures like compost. And we should not use that like fertilizers or chemical substances. And we should not use that like pesticides more in that crops. So next other, and you know that students, we have to be controlled to our how to use that. Means it, especially if the animals suppose died, what you are doing now? We are throwing the rivers. And if suppose any imbalance foods or items or polythenes or vegetables or peels or where almost all we are throwing the outside our water bodies inside, water inside. So we should not do that like which one it create the water pollution. If water is very natural sources and it is very essential part of for the human beings. So I already have told air and water is the very natural source and it is very essential part of the our life to survive. So we have to give attention for the prevention of the water as well as also air. We have to take care. Okay? Thank you. Have a nice day.